to the Married at First Sight Season 13, Episode 9 review. This is Couples Couch with
Pat.
And I'm Cam. Could your name be any more drier? Like, look, I would turn my neck. I am stressed to the point where I don't know if I slept bad or this is just, what do you call this? Tension?
Got a broke neck.
Whatever the case is, I can't move the way I want to move. So I don't know if this is going to get what it's supposed to have gave.
She slept wrong on one of her many naps. Neck seemed to work there.
It didn't. It didn't. And it hurt. Let's get into this week's episode. If you are new to our channel, welcome. You know what I'm going to say? Please be sure to hit the like button and the subscribe button to support our channel. If you are not new, welcome back. You know what I'm also about to say? This will be a high-level overview, more so even
blah, 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 blah. Yo, why do you get the cool yellow Jamaica shirt and I got this mustard brown have a nice day? No one should be stressed out looking like somebody's grandma curtains. Yo, this is the ugliest yellow ever made.
Don't come here with your negative energy. Don't.
I have positive energy.
I then can't you, move.
I get out the shower and you come around with this yellow shirt. No, I don't care. We're going to have Bob Marley shirts on. That's what you told me yesterday. So I'm like, cool. She got my Bob Marley shirt already to the side. I get out the shower.
I can't do everything.
I got this. Have a nice day. How am I supposed to have a nice day?
He come on here so negative.
That, I got a zit on my forehead. Y'all talk about me in the comments.
That's why that's coming out. You're just angry.
It's a horn. Pissed off, man. And then he's... contestants crying. I'm over here dealing with real stuff in these streets. Y'all crying over some fake relationships. Come on, man. Come on with the show.
Episode 9 is titled
Give These People What They Want.
Could This Be Love? Hence why we were going to wear our Bob Marley shirts, but I couldn't find them. My neck ain't giving what it's supposed to have gave to look through the closet. This episode is titled Could This Be Love?
Could this be love? And be love?
Could you be love? Yo. How is you broke down? You out here trying to get in these streets.
I can't. I'm in pain, but I'm trying to give it all I can give.
Could it be love?
It could be love. Right. But now it could be pain.
Yeah. Well,
All right, let's get into this week's episode. Let's talk about this foolery. The show opens up with the couples being married now for 2 weeks.
Two whole weeks.
And they're getting fully immersed in marriage life. Brett and Ryan are eating breakfast. And Brett says she's starting to feel the warm and tinglies now for Ryan. They head downstairs to their lobby to play like Jenga, you know, like the apartment complex has like the little common area. So they're playing Jenga, but just this Jenga is like with a twist. So every time you pull a piece, I believe she reads something that off of a card that she really likes about Ryan.
Sounds horrible. I've been around you 24/7 for 2 weeks. We've been on a vacation together. And I got to look forward to you telling me nice shit about or stuff about myself.
And ooh, Ryan felt so
you got way. Nice eyes.
Because he was like, jeez. Like, unfortunately, he doesn't have anything that he can say. He don't want to build her up with words if he's not really feeling that. Which I could feel him on that. He was like, I don't want to be telling you, oh, you have a nice personality.
Horrible idea and fun games to play. Like, she was too excited for this boring
game.
She was.
And then Ryan low-keyed threw shade and called her Okay Jose when she said she wanted to do this game with... Yeah. That was actually kind of funny.
Can you be excited about some grown folks stuff?
So, that was pretty much their scene. Ryan said he didn't have nothing nice to really say yet.
Because he don't like her.
Because he don't have nothing. He got nothing.
Sorry, Ryan.
We're calling a spade a spade.
I've been calling it.
And with that, let's move on to the next scene. Next, Rachel and Mirla meet up. Rachel heads over to Mirla's apartment to just chop it up a little bit with her. They just talk about their relationship a little bit. And then Rachel notices that Mirla has on one of those rubber rings. And she's like, yeah, you know, Gil got it for me. So when I'm working out, I don't get the original one scratched up. She was like, I did tell him that I want a Cartier. One. And she
go buy it. You seen my savings? Yes. Go buy it. Go get it. I don't care now. Like, now you done seen. You see I ain't got it. So if you want it, go get it. Yeah. I want one too.
Hell, I want one too.
Yeah, let's ball out. Let me get a few dollars to send back to Columbia.
So Rachel was like, "Are you sure he wasn't asleep on this
corner lot?"
He wasn't asleep when he said he would buy one for you, and she was like, "No, he said he would get it," and that was it for their
scene. He gonna have to put out 400,000 fires to get a ring.
You can't buy a house, but you say you're gonna get a Cartier. Is that how you say it? Cartier.
I don't want you to know Cartier. How to say it.
I continue to not know, yeah, so I don't need, like, to get one.
Why I don't go to Starbucks? I don't know how to say anything on the menu, so I can't order.
Grande, Fenty. Done.
Caramel macchiato.
Get out of here, caramel macchiato. We know that much. Scene shows Zach showing back up to the apartment for the first time since they had their housewarming party. He tried to contact Michaela the next day, he said, but she texted him and said for him to only contact her on like this phantom phone number, and she could only text him and not call. Like, what kind of games are we playing here?
Why are you calling her at all?
Well, he still is married to her. So I guess after the housewarming party, he left and decided to say, well, let me hit her up tomorrow and just talk to her, talk things through. And she told him, don't contact her on this phone anymore. Contact her on another phone number and only text, no phone calls. Like, I can't see all of this,
it sounds too.
I don't got the time for none of this.
I can't remember that many numbers. You can't do it.
I'm not doing it with you. So then anyways, he gets there, he sits down, and he starts to talk to her about, you know, the reason why they butt heads, he thinks, is because they have different ways of communicating. And then he proceeds to tell a story about how he sees their life in an analogy, but he uses like a bee.
Under a tree, reading a book of my love life, I got to the chapter of I took the chance to be married at first sight, and I'm very excited to read this book. Then the bee comes along. I'm like, okay, get away, bee, get away. The bee goes away. Should I leave this tree? Because I don't like bees. But and I'm going to stay right here and keep reading this book. I love this book. I want to see where it ends. Another bee comes along. Same situation. I'm like, okay, I'm going to continue to read this book because I really want to see where this book takes me. And then the third bee comes.
That's why you got me wearing this ugly shirt. No! It looked like a bee. I wish I was a bee and I could have been the fourth bee to come and sting you in your stupid head. Leave that girl alone. Why is you calling back? Because you like it. I see you, Zach.
You like
you got female you like tendencies, and I ain't talking. I'm talking just how you deal with stuff. Like, you like the drama.
He likes the chaos.
You like the drama, because if you was really about what you was talking about, she blew up three times, be done.
Yeah.
But like, production going to have to drag me back to film. Oh, I'm going to act like she act. Y'all make me come back. That's what's going to happen. They'll probably love it. They'll be like, we'll edit it up.
This is exactly what we want.
Please, act like she is.
So the whole time we talk about the bees, all I could think about is like killer bees. Like Wu-Tang.
We've just received a report that New York City is under attack by swarms of killer bees. They've been seen approaching from Brooklyn, the Bronx, Queens, and Staten Island. We urge you to stay in your homes at this time, as we will be bringing you up-to-the-minute information. This just in. Police are reporting that there's a man on top of a skyscraper ready to jump. I'm told that he is possibly old, dirty, a member of the Wu-Tang Clan.
Right, real quick.
Police suspect that there could be some connection between this old, dirty man and the killer bees.
I mean, I don't know what any of these songs are. I don't listen to Wu-Tang.
You're thrown out of here.
Get all up in your guts. Fresh banana butter, pecan, chocolate deluxe. Eat the caramel sundae. Scoop up your ice cream truck. Keep it up.
Can you get the money? I do know the song.
My neck is freaking killing me. I did way too much right now. Like, I don't know if I could make it through the rest of this. I'm falling apart, y'all. I don't know, when I lay down, I could like hear something crack back there. What does that mean?
Your wigs are too heavy.
Get off me! Anyways, Zach says the fundamental difference between him and Michaela is how they handle conflict, and he's not happy with how she handles it.
All right. She blows up and he cries.
Next, Bao and Johnny are in their kitchen cooking dinner together. Looks like she's making like some type of salmon.
It looked like lean cuisine. That's why I don't eat at people's house. It had
the
lean cuisine.
Side salad. Yo, with the
pecans was as big as my arm.
Oh, the pecans. Them things were strong. I was like, where'd you get these jumbo pecans from?
The pecans be at the strongman competition every year.
Jeez. So anyways, they sit down and eat. He says it turned out good from what he says.
I seen that lean cuisine with the little sesame seeds on
dressing.
Top. Yeah, slit the top, cook it for 2 minutes, take the top all the way off, cook for another 2 minutes, let's stand for 2 minutes. Tastes like nothing.
I'm not a seafood person, so she couldn't have got me with that meal. I would be like, no, I'm straight on that. But
yeah, I like all my food processed. Don't give me nothing that look fresh.
Oh my God, I can't. So Bao asked Johnny, like, you know, a couple of days ago you made mention that, you know, you weren't in a good headspace about in our marriage. This is high level overview, right? You felt like, you know, you wanted to dip out and run. But where
time
are you
out,
at
time
now?
Out, time out. I'm not feeling your energy. You look uptight.
I almost cursed.
It's the neck. My bad. Go ahead.
I'm going to go lay down, y'all. I'm trying to make it through. Stiff neck and
up. Johnny comes back, and this could be a high level overview. This is high as you get your hand? I thought we was doing a high level overview up here. We doing it out here now.
Do I need to sit back the whole review so I look more relaxed?
You still look like a stiff person leaning back. Now it looks like you can't lean forward, right? I want to lean forward, but I can't.
I am in pain. Okay, I'm trying, y'all. I am trying. The dedication for y'all is real. I want you to understand this. I really should have called out today.
Stop asking for a pat on the back. Cause you know if somebody pat you on your back, you gonna cry.
I can't stand it. Ah! So
been years since I heard that.
I can't. Johnny says that, you know, he pretty much instantly gets mad when she asks him, like, where is he at right now? Has he started to feel better? And he does get very, like, teary-eyed and upset. And you can see all the emotions running through him. And
it's because, like, he ain't got no body fat. It's just skin over tendons, over muscle, over bone. Like, you can see his emotions, his heartbeat.
Johnny says Bao doesn't take time to, you know, take time to know him,
just
know his
me.
Heart.
Just ask
He's
me.
Like, do you ask me, like, how I'm genuinely feeling? Like, in the moment, ask me. Do you know my heart? And Bao's like, well, in the moment, you seem deflated.
Yo.
And she's like, I do ask you questions. And he's like, do you? And he's like getting ready to scream on her. And I'm like, yo, you, first of all, you know, stiff neck and all, this ain't what we about to do right here. I would turn your whole plate over on you.
All this lean cuisine in your lap.
I'm like, first of all, she should have ironed him out for just the, do you? Like, no, first of all, you're not going to talk to me like that. Lower your tone, because I will take you out here, right here at the table. I'm just saying, watch your tone.
But what, am I the only one that doesn't, like, don't ask me nothing. Let me go through life with all my feelings where they should be.
Bottled up.
Right here, behind the ribs, like, tuck it up in there. get a lot of room, get it in there good, and then cinch back down on it and hold it right there.
He want to bottle all of it up. So
how are you feeling? I'm fine.
And he looked like he was about to cry. He wasn't fine. So she did ask him, like, are you okay? How are you doing? And he was like, you know, I just don't like to feel judged. Like, I'm feeling very judged by you right now.
Then you probably shouldn't cry so much. Because people like me judge you on that heavily. Almost exclusively.
And before the tear fell out that bottom lash, they ended their scene. And that was the end of their scene.
He go cry in the car.
Oh, he definitely gonna cry in the car. Let's move on to the next scene. Next, Rachel and Jose are in their bathroom. And Jose was in a petty mood. He decided to pull out Rachel's tube of toothpaste and ask her, why does her tube look like this? And compared to how his looks all nice and pretty. His words, not mine. And he said, she was like, why are you doing this to me? Don't show my toothpaste. She's like, I'm like a sociopath squeezing out my toothpaste. And that's exactly what I thought was going on in that bathroom.
If I was Rachel, I'd have been like, because I was going to brush my teeth and you brought that stupid ass budget board and it pissed me and it shot all over the place. A little bit got on your couch. The part that reclines.
That was it for their
scene. And some got on the roof.
You done? Moving on.
The baseboards.
I'm moving on.
What are those called?
The blinds?
No, the top.
The crown molding?
The crown molding got it on there because those are hella hard to clean.
They are.
I would just go around and dirty his house up with little stuff.
That like would drive puts,
yeah, that's what I would try to do.
I can't.
Like wherever he's got live plants, just go, not a lot of the dirt, just a little bit of it, like just around it. Or do a circle, make him think somebody's doing black magic on him.
I don't have to say. Neck hurt.
All right.
I can't turn to look at you. Let's move on to the next scene.
Why are you sitting like this?
Because I can't see you this way.
We ain't gonna have no clips for the people. You can't even turn and look at the computer good.
Next scene, Rachel and Jose go out for goat yoga. And I'm calling it goat yoga because that's what my six-year-old told me. That's what it's called, goat yoga. And she said, that's what it is. That's what I'm calling it, goat yoga.
When has Peyton been around a goat?
She watched the scene with me when they were putting the goats on their backs. She was like, I don't want to do goat yoga because they'll probably pee on me, is what she said to
they
me.
They will. I know them goats peed on or pooped on somebody.
And Rachel specifically requested the baby goats because they're 2 weeks and younger. I don't know why. Maybe she just wanted baby goats.
I would be on my bad. Like, this goat smells like placenta. It's too fresh.
This goat smell like it should have curry on it.
Yeah, this goat belongs in a stew.
We need to season him real nice. Scotch bonnet pepper. Sorry. I'm sorry.
How much longer y'all got in that yoga?
I'm ready for lunch. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. But
let's wrap this up.
I'm totally kidding. No, we do eat curry goat. We do. We do. And it'd be good. Rice and peas and cabbage. Yes. Sorry. I don't know where to go from here.
Animal rights activists are going to come for you.
We cook this. It's a dish in Jamaica. I'm not trying to say anything. I'm not going to wear its fur. I'm just going to just eat it.
Who wears goat fur? Yo, girl, you seen this goat fur jacket? 17 baby goats. Jacket look like 100% goat ass.
I'm gonna move on. I'm gonna need a leave by the end of this doggone video. All right.
Wear your new goat jacket to the movie. Man. Start bumping up against shit.
I'm sorry. Listen, she requested the baby ones. They did their goat yoga. They had a great time. They pet the little goats, the baby goats and stuff. They had a great time. I personally would not want to do goat yoga. In fear of the baby pee and baby poop that may come out of them at any given time.
Adult pee and adult poop is fine. Baby pee or poop.
I don't want no parts of any of it, to be very honest. So that was it for their scene.
She said she requested baby goats, right? Have you ever been around goats? Mm-hmm. What does...
Not outside of a styrofoam plate. Ba-da-ba-da. And a cola champagne. And a ting. Oh, my neck. Oh, Jesus.
Who is it? Sorry. Not out of a styrofoam.
All right, I'm moving on.
I thought I was supposed to be the funny one.
Next scene, Dr. Pepper is being seen saying that, you know, first come love and then comes marriage. But in this case, the couples did things a little bit differently. Dr. Pepper says that love will grow in time for these couples, but they should be intentional with what they do, like do romantic things, talk from their hearts, share your secrets, and this will help you create that close love connection.
No, then you gotta... Motherflupper, you only known 2 weeks and know all your secrets. Hell no. Don't tell them.
Tell you about Rachel.
Don't tell them nothing. You ever done this? No. You? It's an interrogation. I'm not giving you nothing.
They're creating a case. I'm telling you.
Yeah, 2 weeks. That's the most ridiculous thing I ever heard in my... You know a person, 2 weeks, you tell them your secrets? You ain't got no secrets.
You ain't got nothing left. You ain't got a leg to
you
stand on after.
You an open book whether you want to close it or not. No, sir. My Facebook is blocked, sir.
A leg to stand on after you done told all your secrets?
Yeah.
I can't come back from this because now everything I do, you going to hold that against me going forward.
You know, high school, I wasn't this, that, and the first argument. That's why you was dumb in high school.
I was sharing a moment with you.
I was being, what do you call it?
Transparent.
Yeah, something like that.
The next few scenes are going to be spaceship.
COVID.
Damn. Connected. This is crazy, cuz.
Did you tell them our anniversary was Wednesday?
Okay, sidebar. All right, quick sidebar. Hold on, let me get my angle right, cuz you know I can't turn my neck. Okay. So this Pat. this. That was wicked of you to do that. This past. What day was it?
What's today?
So, Tuesday. This past Tuesday was Patrick's and I 8th wedding anniversary. 10 years together, 8 years married. We passed the 7-year itch. Is that what they say? After like the 7-year itch, then it's like smooth sailing? Or is it like the first 5 years or what is it?
You get an itch, you better put some lotion on it.
Calamine.
We done bought too much shit together. We ain't going nowhere.
We don't have too many investments. We got 2 kids. We got some cars.
Mortgage.
So whatever that you got, you better figure it out and lay yourself down somewhere.
Yeah, if you don't like about me, get over it or ignore it.
And lay yourself down wherever you like. It's plenty
on the
room.
Premises.
On the premises.
Yeah, you go sleep in the attic. I don't care, but you're going to be in this house.
We'll be right here. So, yeah, no, all jokes aside, we made it. That's a huge accomplishment. I'm super happy about that.
Yeah, I didn't think we were going to make it.
Wait a second. I'm moving on. The next few
scenes. So, Tyrone, leave my family alone. We're going to fight for these 8 years.
Really?
10 together. Stay out of my home.
We got a decade together. So, can I get into it?
Yes.
The next few scenes are going to be spaceship level overviews. These scenes are showing the couples asking their assigned questions. So, you know, every season, the Married at First Sight producers give each couple a set of assigned questions to ask each other to drive those deep conversations.
Because they're boring.
I know, because they ain't got nothing else to talk about. So let's get into the first couple. First couple is Johnny and Bao. They're asking each other their assigned questions. Johnny says to Bao, or ask Bao, what will it take for you to fall in love? And what would it take for you to fall in love with me?
30 pounds, muscles, bad body mass.
That's not what she said. That is not what
collagen,
she said.
Collagen. Fat tissue.
Stop.
You know? Do they implant fat? I know they suck it out.
Transfer.
Do they
yes.
push it in?
It's called transferring of fat.
All right,
that's
he needs
that. A lot
that.
Of people do.
He needs that.
Stop. Anyway, Bao says she still wants to find more common ground with Johnny and says that she's lucky to have him as a husband. And then he proceeds to bawl. Almost. Like it gets there.
When you almost cry this much, it's a cry.
So right. he...
Just give in,
it's
bro.
Just a full-on cry.
Yeah, you already lost my respect. Just get your cry out. You had to do it. You know you want to feel the tears running down your cheeks. I don't know what it is. Go ahead, cry.
He grabs her, takes her into the room to get it on. That was it for their scene. Next, Brett and Ryan are...
And all I could imagine was like blurred faces and genitalia.
You're trying to kill me today. I can see. That you're so awful. Yo, I can't
I'm
take
sorry.
Much more.
That'd be so funny to me.
Next, Brett and Ryan are up. They're having dinner and they're asking each other their assigned questions. Brett asks Ryan, have you been in love? He says yes twice. And then Brett proceeds to ask Ryan, what's gonna make you fall in love?
Somebody else. You signing over the rights to your dog.
Baxter. He wants Baxter.
Yeah.
Ryan says he felt like in his past relationships he could have been in love, but he took too long to make the move or to act on it or say he loved the person. The person was like, yo, peace out.
That ain't love.
A-town down peace. Was it?
That ain't love. If you could just be like, oh, we missed our timing in the night. That wasn't love.
You know
love
what?
Will have you in love with bushes. Okay? Love will have you sitting in the Cadillac out front the club in your bathrobe with a black and mild. That's what love is. I got halfway through and I was like, shut up, because you might be in the club or in the parking lot of the club.
For who? Looking for me?
And Tyrone.
All right. Next up. Mirla and Gil, they're sitting down asking their questions. Gil asks Mirla, or Mirla asks Gil, is he falling in love? He said that his coordinates are in line to fall in love, so he's on the right track, but he's not there yet. That was it for their scene. Next, Rachel and Jose are asking each other the same kind of questions. Rachel says that there are communication issues with Jose for her. She said that he's too busy sitting and thinking about his answer to the next question or looking at his phone. They start to have like a communication breakdown even while asking the questions
because
he's
care.
Not listening.
He don't care. It ain't that he don't listen. He don't care what you got to say.
He's not talking, not listening. He don't listen. He's just doing his own thing. And then Jose reveals that he was in a 4-year relationship with a woman. But she had kids, and he couldn't see himself married to her. So they just apparently are not together.
That's the dumbest thing ever.
And he said it was a strong like for him, not a love.
That's the dumbest thing
ever. I been with somebody for four full years.
And he said he knew right from the gate you wasn't ever going to be. So why did you waste that woman and her kids' time?
Yeah, especially the kids. You know, don't do that. Don't now do you that. Got
little kids running around thinking that edging your beard from the inside out is cool. It's not. That's what you did. Ruin those kids' life. All their life, they're going to be walking around with this all right here looking extra pale.
Shouldn't have wasted more than anything the kids' time. Don't get involved with somebody who has kids, in my opinion, and waste their time because that's not right.
And a husband to live with her, Tyrone. Yeah, don't waste our time. Leave our kids alone.
What? I'm moving on.
Saw the text message.
Get out of here. I'm moving on.
You and the kids gonna be able to go to the zoo this weekend?
You're a whole ass lie. I'm moving on to the next scene. Next, Miguela and Zach have made it out to date night.
And they're the only ones in this four-story, like, tent. It looked like a tent. Like,
they were having a good time. Beautiful. But they brought their assigned questions with them.
This is beautiful. I'm going to drink this.
To the restaurant.
Carrot blueberry drink. Like, they brought their own drinks. Didn't nobody serve them that?
I don't know what was going on there, but they brought their assigned questions with them, and they talk about how or have they fell in love. Zach reveals that there's a checklist for him in order to have fell in love with women. He said he's never fallen in love with a girl that he's dated in the past because they didn't meet the criteria on the checklist, like their looks or ambition or I remember intelligent was there.
Gender.
Trust and honesty was also on there. He had a pretty lengthy list, and Miguela was sitting there like, while these things were good points that he, because he named some good things on the checklist, Miguela was looking a little like, I don't know if I can meet the expectation.
I'm about to pull a Jose because I could care less about these.
Okay, things. Well then that's it for their scene. Zach asked Miguela,
do we really care? If they not blowing up, do we really care?
No. But I got to give it to the people who haven't watched
it's
the episode.
It's our show. We don't got to give them nothing. They're here for the jokes.
Okay, let me just tell them what Zach
Nobody asked her. Went crazy right now. Next scene.
Zach asked Miguela, do you think that you're falling in love? She said she thought she was falling in love a couple of weeks ago.
How?
I don't know, but she said now she's guarded.
COVID in 2 days?
And she thought she was falling in love. People fall in love faster than you realize.
No, they don't. They do not.
Faster than I would. Let me say that. They're not in they love. Have a good night and they move on. And that was it for their scene. He said, oh, having a date night like that makes them happy. Feels like they're going in the right direction to get back to where they were.
And that so was that means y'all can't be around each other and just be at peace. Y'all gotta be out doing something. You gotta be. That's what that means.
That's what it sounds like to me. A little bit. Not all the way, but a little bit. You know. Anyway, let's move on. Bao and Johnny are in their bed, and she shows that long pillow that he always has to separate the two of them is now on the end of the bed, and now they're cuddled up together. So she's saying this is showing progress that they're getting closer.
And I was amazed.
Were you really?
That the room didn't catch on fire.
Why?
Because them two stick people rubbing together as fast as they probably was. I'm surprised they didn't start a fire.
You made me break my neck today trying to laugh at you.
Like two stick people.
I'm moving on to the next scene.
Johnny poking people with pelvis bones.
Next few scenes are date nights for the couples. High level overview, of course. Next scene shows that they're planning special dates for each other. Jose and Rachel are sitting down in their apartment for their date night, and he comes home with coasters that are also Scrabble pieces that they can create their own custom coaster.
Sounds horrible.
I know Patrick would never. He would never be thinking that he's gonna bring home something to do work with, like, cause that would be work for him. Like, what? So we're gonna sit here and glue
now
what?
I got a spell. You brought a gift home, you know I don't spell good, and you brought a gift home where we gotta spell stuff.
He would never.
Like, you trying to come for me. That's
he
how
would
I feel
never, never.
Ass, is that on there? All right, so put they, hole going down the other way. That's what you are right now.
So they
playing with me, man. You know I went to this special class down the hallway. You want to bring Scrabble?
He really did.
He's bringing like, games. I can't even spell the name of the game.
He ain't talking nothing sideways. He really was in that class. Oh,
I mean, I you didn't even know me in high school.
I thought we were sharing.
This way you don't tell nobody nothing after 2 weeks. 10 years into the game, she threw it out.
You I don't have nothing. Me? Listen, I love you. You can read and you can, you is smart.
I hate you. I hate you. I hate you.
You is beautiful.
Move on.
So they stumble over the topic of how did she end up cheating on her ex. Rachel tells the story that it happened during year two of her 8-year relationship. She was out one night for girls' night. Alcohol was
involved. No wonder he was controlling. You was out here in the streets. Yo, why do people do that shit? Like, I broke up with my ex. He was so controlling. When he wasn't controlling, you was out sleeping with the next man.
Jesus, let me just finish.
Explain how cheating for her was okay.
No, I'm not.
They make movies off of it.
Can you?
And you watch them, and that pisses. Oh, I hate the movie.
He's talking about that Tyler Perry movie, Temptation. Do you remember that movie, y'all? Drop a comment. Drop a yellow heart in the comment
section. It's not just that movie. Any movie where the woman is cheating, they always cuss. No, because when a man cheats in a movie, he's a dirtbag, he's dirty, and all this other stuff. When a woman cheats on
TV, payback.
When a woman cheats on TV, they portray it like, oh, well, her husband doesn't give her what she wants, so she's not really spreading her legs for the next man. She's just receiving his attention. Get the hell out of here.
So, hoe,
you know you a hoe.
I can't.
How do I know? Because you told me so. You a hoe? Oh, we can't do that intermission? We got a song for everything else.
It happened during year two of their 8-year relationship. She said she was out one night for girls' night, and alcohol was involved, and she bumped into someone from her past. And it happened. She said the next day she had to tell her boyfriend.
Get the hell out of here.
And he forgave her.
She a lie.
He forgave her.
She a lie.
And Jose.
Street. She for the streets. She for the streets. She street meat. If she cheated 2 years in, I'm not going to believe that she was faithful for the other six. So for 3/4 of her relationship, she was street meat. That's what you use, street meat.
Me.
You for the streets. I'm supposed to believe.
Her boyfriend forgave her.
Alright, well he for the streets too.
He probably was.
That's why he was controlling afterwards. He didn't forgive her. He watched over her. He kept tabs on her. Hey, why? I'm following your phone. I got a bank account.
Jose said that, you know, he's sorry, but if she cheats on him, he's not going to forgive her. And he also asked
her,
like, how is he supposed to feel?
You're not going to get your stuff out the house.
He said, how is he supposed to feel knowing when she now goes out for date night? Like, how does she know that something's not going to, how does he know that something's not going to happen? She said, honestly, you just going to have to trust me.
Yeah, you crazy as hell. I ain't trusting you for nothing.
You just got to trust
me. I couldn't trust you to wash your face when you was a teenager. You ended up with acne. Now I'm supposed to trust you with a relationship? You out your rabbit.
Mirla and Gil are having date night at home. They turn down for bed, and Gil decides to offer her a foot massage, and she's like, "Oh, you're being weird or whatever." And so he pulls out the value size cocoa butter and decides to massage her foot, and she could care less. She looks like she's not really interested. And then she's like, well, you know, this would feel better if I was tired or if my feet hurt. And he was like, your feet don't hurt? And she's like, no, because I work from home. So pretty much I felt like she was giving you wasting your time here. And I don't really, I'm not into this.
I would have been like, well, your face look like your feet smell like corn chips. What she is said, this?
It's just
what like is this?
Sunburn. It's like a
what
sunburn.
What, you was wearing goggles?
Swimming underwater?
Yeah. What is you doing in Houston?
I don't know. I have no idea. She says if she had to rate his foot massage, it would be a 5-ish. And she says, Gil says that trying to please his wife romantically is a hard job. She's very hard to please. I say she's ungrateful. You say she's hard to please. Tomato, tomato. Let's move on to the next
I
scene.
Say she's a...
Bao and Johnny have date night. Bao reveals that they consummated their marriage, but she doesn't really say it directly like that. She's like, we may or may have not consummated our marriage.
She couldn't tell if it went in. She couldn't see through the...
I don't know why they have to be so immature about it. We may or may have not. Y'all are married.
Ain't I knocked the walls down, man. What are you talking about? You don't see her walking funny? Bao, come here.
So they have like these little toy guns and they decide to play. And Johnny bet her that if he wins, he gets to do whatever he wants to do to her in the bedroom tonight. And she, if she wins, she gets to do whatever she wants to do to him.
Go to sleep. That's my experience. You win. All right, we're going to go straight to sleep.
You don't know how to play the
come
game.
Come on, only give me that trick one time. All right, you win. And you get whatever you want.
And I win. I get to do whatever I want to do to you tonight. Cover his ass with a blanket. Anger. That's what I want to do with you. Yeah. I'm sorry. This is 10 years, y'all. 10 years. We ain't going nowhere. We got another decade to go.
Not at that rate.
Shut up. So anyways, Johnny
You got a Tyrone? Go get me a Tanya.
Tanya and Tyrone? So Johnny wins the gun game. They shoot it up and they have those little styrofoam targets and stuff. He wins.
And the next scene is Bao's hanging upside down, wrapped in saran with a ball in the mouth.
And Dexter's coming with the plastic.
Hands tied upside down. Should've got better with the water guns.
Next scene is the barbecue at Jose's house. Rachel and Jose are hosting at Jose's house, and she says that she's excited to have everyone over and that she can really see herself living here, which is cool. Mirla shows up and she's like, I usually don't go to people's homes. I'm really not extroverted like that. I've only been to one barbecue since I've been here to Houston.
It's a reason
I don't plan to come back to their house out here in the middle of nowhere.
One, two, three. Mirla's a bitch.
I'm like, you're just being some kind of way. For what reason? These people are trying to be nice to you. And they say they would like for this to be an annual thing. You know, hopefully.
You know Jose want to come off and show his house every year.
You got to give that
y'all
tour.
Y'all remember the banister last year? We put a fresh coat on it. Just this. What was that, baby? Was that in October?
That was in October. We
went
to Lowe's.
Yeah, it was in October because we wanted to do it before it got too cold.
Yeah,
you
know, and Lowe's was having that deal.
Yeah. And we had eggshell on the wall, but you know, decided. She likes a little color, so we got taupe eggshell.
And zhuzh it up a little bit. That would be them. That's going to be them at their second annual barbecue.
No, Rachel's going to be sitting there rolling her eyes like she always
is. During the barbecue, they bring up the dispute between him and Mirla. Mirla believes that people don't just fall in love, that they choose to fall in love.
Yes.
Oh, you agree with her?
Yeah. Wait, who?
Mirla.
No.
You agree with her?
I explain mine differently.
She says, Gil reveals that Mirla still has not kissed him, but the affection has increased. Meanwhile, Brett says she doesn't want to compare her relationship to anyone else's, but just looking around the room, she feels like her and Ryan don't have the same connection like everybody else right now.
Because he don't like you.
Sorry, I couldn't find my page, so I had to get in the...
I think I got it here. Let me send it over.
Over here.
Let me send it over to you.
I know what they call people who type everything they hear.
Stenographer.
Okay. So, Brett says that she doesn't want to compare, but she feels like the connection that everybody else is showing each other in the room isn't the same between her and Ryan.
Hold on, Brett.
So,
yep. Oh. He don't like you.
So they start to do like a guess around the room, like who would say I love you first, and majority rules that Johnny will say I love you first out of everybody, out of all the couples.
And then run off to another state and not come back. He won both categories. First to say I love you, first to ditch his family.
Stop!
Like father, like son.
Stop!
I'm sorry! I'm mean!
Yes, you are. All right. Next scene, they all branch off for a bit. You know how they always do, and a few groups go talk to each other. Oh my God. Jose's in his room talking to Michaela and, I'm sorry, not Michaela, Mirla and Gil and... Brett is in there and he's telling everybody about the room and he's rambling so much so I don't know what
Jose. And you know I got an 815 credit score, right?
The only thing I could
and I paid off two houses.
Mirla and Brett in his bed, like that's one thing. I don't know, it must be an island thing, but we were raised to not allow people in their outside clothes in
your bed. I'm an adult. Why are you in my room anyway?
In my, on my bed.
Why do you have to? I still, when even when we have people over and you take them on a tour, I still don't understand what I got to see the room.
Right. You walk in, you be like, oh, okay, this is nice. If you want to show them what, you know, the master bedroom looks like or any of the bedrooms look like.
I don't want to show them anything. I don't want them in my house.
I was like, you could just come sit here at the island.
I bought all this stuff for me, not for nobody else.
They were all laying on his bed. Like, that rubbed me wrong. I'm like, oh, the germs. But anyway, Michaela decides to share a little bit about their relationship, saying that they've had some lows and some highs. And then Zach is out back saying pretty much the same thing to those guys that, you know, Michaela's a nice person and all, but they've had some highs and lows. And then Michaela's in the kitchen saying that she couldn't have built a better man if she wanted to. And I'm thinking, this is not how you be acting at the house, talking about you couldn't have built a better man. You know what I mean? Like, it's so
fake.
Happened. Ryan shares with the guys that he shared his past with Brett. I know, I'm trying. And he told her that he is waiting for a feeling that he still doesn't feel.
Increasing altitude, going up another 10,000 feet.
And then he says, Brett is in the bedroom with the guys and stuff.
Increase airspeed.
Saying that Brett's Ryan.
Hey, passengers, can y'all sit down and put your seatbelts on? We're about to make this go a little bit quicker, get where we're trying to go.
Brett says, Ryan says there isn't a spark between them. And she says that you can't just sit back and wait for the spark to come. You got to do stuff to get the spark going because their situation isn't ideal.
Bow and Johnny had to rub sticks together.
I'm moving on. Next, Rachel is shown saying that the mood is awkward right now because she told Jose that she loves him and he didn't say anything back. And then she's like, just kidding. He told me I love you too. So now they both say I love you to each other. And that was it pretty much. So now they're in love.
And they say it way too much, probably.
And it's just too soon. 2 weeks and you already saying, I love you. But, you know, do you, boo-boo, whatever works for you. So that was it for their scene.
Who got the better credit score?
Well,
I think he knows best then. Did you pay off two houses?
Sally Mae.
Sally Mae's still coming for you. Well, I think you better listen to Jose.
That was it for their scene. Let's move on.
Did you make your father silent and your stepmom try to tell on you?
You see, I be trying to not get into the nitty gritty. Y'all see who be holding me up.
Let's go.
Now you want to go. Let's move on to the next scene. Zach comes home and surprises Michaela with a cooking lesson from a chef on Zoom. So the chef is on the computer telling them how to make shrimp scampi. They cook together as a team. Michaela's in charge of seasoning. He said that she don't know how to season very well. This one's showing me shoes. He says she's too heavy-handed with the seasoning and they gonna have
to work
on it.
Who don't know how to season?
Season, not Susan.
Who don't know how to season?
Michaela.
This is bullshit. You gonna bring the only? All right,
just leave it there. Leave it there. Zach said turned out too spicy, and he had to run to the fridge and grab some water because it was just over seasoned or over spiced. So it was too spicy. He had to cool himself down. That was pretty much it for their
scene. Makes sense.
They worked together.
That makes sense.
It was too much.
It
was extra.
That he couldn't take seasoning.
I'm done. Okay, I'm moving on to the next scene.
Yeah, you can take it.
Bow and Johnny do art night. Johnny has it all set up for her. at their house as a surprise. Johnny says that he's trying to redeem himself from ghosting Bao from when he ghosted her for taking her to the art museum. While painting, Bao starts to like freak out because she's like, it's getting too dark, the colors are not perfect, and you can see Johnny starting to like fall apart because
painted four lines on a paper. You had like blue, orange, yellow, brown,
and that was it.
That was like, and they went across, like
across, and it was nothing.
Oh my god, it's not right. It ain't wrong. It ain't nothing.
It ain't nothing. It ain't nothing. Like, just enjoy your life.
And then he go like
starts falling apart because he's like, well, now it's the flirtation is gone and the tension is gone, and there's it's now she now it feels like a task, and they are both meant to be. Because they both are the same kind. Just like...
annoying?
Yeah. Like y'all both falling apart over a canvas painting from Hobby Lobby.
I wouldn't want to hang out with any... well, maybe Ryan. I wouldn't want to hang out with any of these other people.
Not Zach neither?
No. Guys, those guys over at the other table are talking to us. Dude, I'm just upset right now. Fuck, I want to hang... why do I want to hang out with that dude? Oh, I'm good. You want to go get a beer? No.
So Johnny says the fun is gone and he feels annoyed. And that was pretty much it for their scene. Let's move on to the final few scenes of this episode. In the final few scenes of this episode, Gil and Mila are out at a restaurant, a place where Mila said she saw a blogger have a really pretty drink called Chanel No. 6. And she just has to... have it. And Gil says, well, what if the drink was called Knockoff Number 4? Would you still want to be here and have the drink? And she was like, no. Like, I like fancy drinks. I like
pretty drinks. But you a knockoff J-Lo. And not a good one.
He kind of right, though.
Like, you a plain Jane, basic model, cloth interior.
Not cloth, no radio. They don't come with the empty hole just in there. Just kidding.
You came with a ding on the front bumper.
I'm just kidding. Gil said, this is cool, but this doesn't interest him because he doesn't like to eat out much. Mila said
she ever does is about him.
No, it's all about her.
Cookies.
It's all about her. She said she likes to go to brunch every weekend. She likes to eat out twice a month. That's what she wants to do. She wants Gil to be her brunch partner.
She wants brunch a girlfriend. Husband. She wants a girlfriend, but she probably ain't got no friends that can stand hanging out with her. Or all her girlfriends got men.
Right. So she's like, well, I really want you to be my brunch husband. And I think it struck a nerve with Gil when she said that. Mm-hmm. He was like, well, I want you to understand that the goal here is to aim for love in this marriage. Not like that you just have any silhouette sitting here with the
not
ring finger on.
Not me kissing your ass all the time.
Okay, say yeah, what there it is. There's, you know,
like, I'm not like running behind you.
Right, there's and difference, doing what you want to do.
Yeah, there's a difference between, you know, chasing after a girl you interested in, right, and you trying to start something with, and running behind a girl trying to appease everything she wants just so she keeps you around.
Exactly. So that's where Gil says, I want to feel wanted, you know, and I need you to show me that you want me. And he was firm. I love every minute of this. And all she could come back with and say is, I want you to be my brunch husband.
Because or do brunches she with basic. Me.
And that was the end of episode 9.
Ordinary.
It's just like, what are you thinking? Like, you can't be putting out, like, this type of energy to be like, well,
I want to... That's who she is. She's not putting out that energy. That is her energy.
And her energy is wackadoodle. I don't like it.
Good for
her. At all. So that was the end of episode 9. Drop your comments in the comment section below. What did you think about this episode? Personally, I felt like this episode is a buildup. Because I feel like Gil is about to lose his mind on her. I feel like Jose and Rachel are about to fall out about something related to their relationship. Because he's already saying he don't trust that. Mm. And then we got Zach and Michaela. That's always a build up to their next argument. So I just felt like this was a build up episode. Because I'm sure next week is going to be something else.
I hope so.
So drop your comments in the comment section below. We would love to hear from you. We love talking to you. Again, this week we had almost 400 comments.
Well, can some of them comments tell Kamara to put me in something decent? Come on, y'all. Like, this, no
this
effort.
This might happen with my
no
naked
effort. This was a Mila effort shirt. You put as much effort into my shirt this week as Mila did for that date night.
I'm sorry. Listen.
Deuces,
that's
y'all.
That's all I can give. Wait, let me finish. So be sure to hit the like button and the subscribe button to support our channel.
You moving
also,
my neck around because you can't move yours?
And thank
grab
you.
My whole head? I'm not a bobblehead.
Geppetto. And thank you so much for watching, you guys. We really thank you. And we will see you in next week's
episode.
For
the fourth time. Deuces. I'm out. Close it out on your own. Done. Come on, Dallas. Let's go outside.
Watching. Bye, everybody.